Hey guys, VB programming here, and now I'm going to show you how to set up a form. So, and design it for you. So first you want to pick a new project. You want to name it what you want. I will put form design. Tutorial. And now it's creating it. See on the bottom. So it has created it. So this is a form. So it's pretty much the back of it, of our program. So you wanna click it right and left click it, and then you'll see in properties. So what this does, this is the name for the form when you're gonna use it in coding, what you wanna name it. I keep it the same. And there's this back color. That's the color of the background. Well, let's put it like that. Or you could add an image. Example. Let's see what image I got. Now this is Minecraft image. Minecraft. See, it shows Minecraft. But you could also right click, reset, and it'll take it off. Reset the process. Okay, so now you scroll it down. And there's the font. This is the way it types, like when you're gonna type something on the form. So pretty much you just put whatever you want. I'm gonna put this one. Called impact, like, well, maybe form, whatever. And this is the color of the text, of the word. So I'm just gonna put this bluish. And I'm gonna scroll it down. So this is the form board. So this is this thing. I could change the little background, like, thing. So what you can do is you can put none, you can put fixed angle, you can put fixed 3D, fixed dialogue, sizable is regular, fixed tool window, and sizable tool window. I like the sizable one, so I'm keep it like that. And this is an icon. So what this does, it's an icon file that you could use for, like, there's a converter for online, and .ico files. This is an icon, like in the program. For example, I believe I have something here. Yeah, I have this. I'm gonna put this, whatever. Now it has an icon in, built in. So you scroll a little down, you find the size, that automatically changes to this. And this is a spark edition. So you can make it, this window's default location is going to be right here. Right here. Center screen is going to be in the center, of course. Center parent will be in the center, but more, like, very, 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 like, it'll just be there, like, very estimated or something. And I like center screen. Now this is the name of the form. This goes up there. So what I name, is I'm gonna name it form design tutorial. So that's it. Now I'm gonna show you what other things do. I'm gonna leave the back color black. And now we're gonna just mess around here. I'm going to show you what some of these things do. Pointer is just moving the mouse, but this button, it's a button. You see the button. You could click on the button. And then it has the properties here, button one. And you could change the grandfather to whatever crap. And it's the same thing, except for they have a flat style. So you can make it like that. You see? It looks sick like that. That's called a flat. This is pop up. This is standard, isn't it? And this is system. I like flat. And this is the font of the button. It's the same as we showed earlier, but you can change it. This is the color. And we have the button too. I'm gonna make this the name. I'm gonna put welcome. Okay. Whatever. I'm gonna make it so new. Now, if you double click it, the button, we're gonna type in MST box parentheses. And inside have double lines, and you want to type in whatever you want, but I'm typing welcome to my form design. Okay, so now it does that. I'm gonna put it there, and then we have after the button we have the checkbox. So pretty much you just check it. Not a big deal. And next we have the checklist box. This is the list box. So you just check the list box, the items you want, and it does it like it does what you made it do. I personally like the list box because it can make a bunch of titles on it. And next we have the the combo box. So this pretty much is a drop down. So I could type in here contact display or whatever. And then you can make it so they click that. Whatever you type there, it'll do. Then we have a daytime ticket. So it'll say the day of the day. It's sort of a calendar. Okay. So that's it for that. And now we got a label. This is what I was saying earlier. This is the label. See? Now we can name the label form, like whatever you want. I'm gonna name it form design label, and you can make it bigger and shit by putting the font bigger. Okay, and we could the toolbox link label. Now this, when you double click it, you put like a website here. And then they double click the link, the label, and it'll like send them to the internet with that link that you put there. This is a list box. It shows a list. And you can select only one thing at a time. It's pretty useful. There's also the list view. So you could view things in your list. You have to have the list box. And then we have the math text box. Which is just like a text box, but like it's like a little more complicated. But that is normal. So next we have the month calendar. Now this is a calendar. Oh, select today, today, crap. So we're gonna keep it like that. And we have a notify icon. That means it will say warning, you have a virus or whatever you want it to say. Error. This is still getting error. And we have this notable number thing. So each time it's like a number scroller. Up goes one and down goes the highest number or negative. It depends on how you put it. We have a picture box. Now this is very useful. You could like show a picture. For example, I'm gonna show this picture. Minecraft. You see the picture, I can make it huge. Or whatever. So I'm just gonna do that. We could we have the progress bar. Now this is very good. I could make a progress bar down here. I could do this. Or whatever. Progress bar. I can make it scroll if I want. You click it as value 0. I put a 45 and crap. But there's a way to make it go when the form opens, and I'll show it later. We have the radio button. It's just like the button, but it's like a checklist, a check later, or whatever it's called. A check button. Checkbox, and check. And we have the read text box. It's like a notepad, whatever. Notepad-ish. Type whatever you want on it. We'll put form design, whatever. Okay. We have the text box. Exactly like the rich text box and the mass text box. So this one is left on. But you see, you can mess around with the properties of each thing in the toolbox. So here, I'm gonna type in what is your name? What is your or whatever you want. I'm gonna be blank. And you can make this this text box, but it'll still be that. You click here, and it'll be a multi-line. So that means you could enlarge it like this, like text box. After that, we have the tooltip. It's not that important. And we have a preview. I don't use that, and I use the web browser. So pretty much this is the internet. I'm going to type in here www.youtube.com. That's it. And now, when this thing opens, I'm going to do that. You can do that. For YouTube. And there we go. And that's pretty much for right now. The common control. Now we're gonna do containers. I don't use none of them except for the blue box to make it look good. And now these are important right now. Get you confused, and this is very good. It's called the timer. It keeps track, it repeats everything you make it do non-stop until you click a stop button or something. And that's pretty much all for today of making the form thing. And I'm gonna show you how to make a diet too. So what you want to do is you want to click save all or whatever. And when it says this, do not uncheck mark it. It has to be like that. if it's check mark, you can have the .exe. So now I'm going to put this in my downloads folder. Let's save it. Save it. And now we're going to click debug and build. Let it build on the bottom. When it says build succeed, it has been built. You go to your download, and it's right here. You get a pin, release, and the tools right here. You see? And now you click welcome. Welcome to my form design kit. That's progress bar. Just right here. See, it has the icon that I put. See, it has YouTube here. Just says part 2, so I think it's big enough. YouTube. Well, that's pretty much all for today. And hopefully you guys can design it. Now you could design it. It's your thing very often. The form looks like it's good now. Well, tomorrow we'll actually start programming, and we will make a tool. It's called the Skype spammer. Pretty much like not a Skype spammer, but like a spammer. So it spams anything you want. But next after that, we're gonna make more spammers. Like 3 spammer tutorials. Each one gets better, and then I'll see what else we do. Okay guys, later.